Maryhill locks and basins, locks 21 to 25. This flight of five locks and connected basins is one of the most picturesque on the Forth and Clyde Canal. A tranquil spot today, it was once a very busy stretch of the canal. Indeed, the basins were incorporated into the design of this lock flight so that numerous ships could travel through it together, so avoiding a bottleneck. The idea of connecting the Firths of Forth and Clyde by canal was first mooted in 1724 by the author of Robinson Crusoe, Daniel Defoe. Nearly 45 years later, the advance of innovation and industry across Scotland increased the need for an efficient inland transport system. The construction work started at Grangemouth in June 1768. After a few pauses when money ran out, the Forth and Clyde Canal, or Great Canal as it was known, finally opened with a flourish in July 1790. The Forth and Clyde Canal was the world's first man-made sea-to-sea canal and the biggest single construction venture undertaken in Scotland at the time. It wasn't long before the 35-mile-long waterway was at the heart of industries flourishing between its gateways at Grangemouth on the east coast and Bowling on the west coast, as well as along the 3-mile spur into Glasgow. The Forth and Clyde Canal was hugely influential in the industrial and social growth of the city 200 years ago. Today they are becoming important and relevant once more as we enjoy the heritage, the waterway, wildlife, and the attractive traffic-free green open space of the towpaths.